Hello YouTube, welcome back to game number 3 between ShoWTime and FireCake. This is going to be a best of 5 currently on... Actually, I won't say just yet. If you haven't seen the previous videos, please, there's annotations on the top of the screen on... I believe it's only if you're on desktop. If not, go on my videos list and watch the previous videos. It'll be very important to not miss the first two games. And... Okay. So, spoilers are now coming. The first two games were actually taken by Firecake with some crazy, absolutely crazy plays doing this extractor trick for the third time. Now, I really, really do need to check what the actual economic difference is if you do that versus the standard double drone overlord play. But that's pretty much it. Let's see how this plays out. So, as I said, this is game number 3. It's all depending on this one. If ShoWTime can hold on in this one, it could go on to game number 4 and 5. But it really does depend. Will he finish this game at a loss or not? Is going to be opening with an early Nexus. Now, every game so far, as far as I can remember, yes. Firecake has actually started off with a double expansion at the very beginning. In this case, oh my god, is he really doing this? Yes, he is indeed, and he's opening with a gold base for the second one. So ShoWTime is actually predicting it to be in this one, but it does look like he was expecting it to be this one because it's the most common base for the Zerg to take. But instead, he has actually taken a different base. So let's quickly highlight that probe again. I can't quite catch it. There we go. So he's seen this expansion. He hasn't seen the second expansion yet. He could potentially be getting a little bit curious as to what's going on at the moment. He is going to see that spawning pool coming down at about 145. Usually with one base up, you would actually get it completed at about 2 minutes, which is only 15 seconds later. So he's going to know that something is up. Not quite sure why he's not gone to scout out this site, because that is, of course, another gold base. This map, by the way, one of the highest gold base count in all of StarCraft 2 Legacy of the Void at the moment. I believe there is a total of 4 in this tiny little map. Yeah, there is a total of 4 on the map. Sorry, my mistake. 6. 6 in total. So yeah, he has indeed seen this expansion coming out. So he has thrown down extra gateways at the moment. There's a cybernetic core and 3 gateways at this time. Only one gas, so potentially going to see some further expansion or further non-gas builds, since one gas is not really going to get him that far. Probably going to throw out triple adepts though, that's what I'm seeing happening. There we go, triple adepts coming out, two of them getting boosted out, which is quite normal. Gateway also on the way. Does look like Overlord is here, going to be aware of exactly what's going on. Does see three gateways, so he's going to be expecting some aggression here. Does throw out a few Zerglings, as you can see. Decides to get Zerglings out of this also before going for drones, which I suppose is quite a good response, seeing as he's going to have a lot of aggression from these Adepts right now. Is boosting out more. Now, this Overlord is seeing this. He is seeing this perfectly. He's going to see that at the moment there is 3 Adepts on the field already, and he's continuing to make more out of this gateway. So he knows he's going to be expecting a bigger army to come out, not going to be expecting any sort of, you know, small harassments. And that's exactly what we're going to be expecting to see also. So more and more Adepts being produced. He's deciding to go pretty much all in with this double base play. 9 Adepts currently on the way. Now, if you notice this, notice the production for Firecake also. He is producing lots and lots of Zerglings. He's probably going to want to wait until Metabolic Boost is up. At that point, he will be able to combat these quite easily with the number of Zerglings that he does have. But slowly, at the moment, he is going to be losing the Zerglings if he cannot catch up to the Adepts. And now it's going to be up. There we go. Now in a position to surround them. Do a crazy amount of damage. A few of these are going to get dropped before they manage to Psionic Transfer. 3 in total, I believe. 4... Yes, that was 4 in total taken out without getting destroyed. So at this point, not going to be that much that ShoWTime can do with these Adepts. Maybe take out a few Zerglings, but that is pretty much it. There we go. There's 3 Adepts standing here. 5 actually in total with the Psionic Transfer. Nothing that those Zerglings can do. They're not going to be able to get in here no matter what they do. They would get destroyed before they break through completely. Now, Roachborn is on the way for Firecake. So I'm wondering, is he going to opt to get a lair and then a Nidus Swarm? I honestly don't know. That may be a good response here, because at the moment all that ShoWTime has really are Adepts, and he's warping in more and more at the moment. Now, once these roaches are up, these Adepts are going to become very, very limited in use, because roaches are pretty damn good against them. And if you look at the damage there, 10 damage versus normal or heavy units, which roaches are, or it's 23 versus light. So obviously they two-shot Zerglings, but versus roaches, they're going to need about 13 hits. That's without armor. So 14 hits with any armor upgrade on a roach, which of course is a disaster for this many adepts. Not being able to one-shot. I mean, how many is that? That is 8, 12. 12 of these will not be able to one-shot one single roach. So yeah, definitely want to start getting different units out of this. He does have a robotics bay coming out, or robotics facility rather, which is going to enable him to create immortals or potentially also disruptors, which would be equally as beneficial to him. Now there we go. As I said, the roaches are going to be doing a little bit of damage here. Not that much that they can do against roaches. Level 1 weapons also going down for the Protoss player. An Immortal coming out. Robotics Bay also coming out, which I suspect is going to be used for Disruptors. Would be a good response. Now, another gold expansion coming out for ShoWTime. Good response also, because he needs to get that economy rolling. He can't let a Zerg player sit on 3 bases ahead. And sorry, 1 base ahead, which includes a gold base, which essentially makes this like a double base. Definitely wants to do a bit of aggression against this. Now, he does decide to bring these adepts in with the psionic transfer. They will get very, very quickly caught out here. Gonna get surrounded. So he's gonna want to bring them on out of here with the psionic transfer. It is already ready. So definitely wants to start that going. Is losing units very, very quickly at this point. More and more of these units dropping. And is he gonna get them out? Yes, he is indeed. Bringing them on over here into the natural. But so few of them remaining at this point. He is deciding to bring out further gateways, and of course a photon cannon here. Now, based on the amount of units and the supply for the Zerg player, there's not going to be that much that he can do at this point. He needs to get more units up. He needs to get a bunch of immortals. Oh my god, look at the amount of ravagers being made. So even if there's going to be a wall going to be going down here, the ravagers will be able to take it out quite quickly with their corrosive biles. And here we go, the Zerg streaming straight in. There's about a 60, or about 55 actually, supply difference between these two players. I honestly don't see ShoWTime holding on here at all. One pylon getting quickly sniped out. Never mind, one health remaining. Does put down one more. This overcharge not doing a whole lot of damage. Mothership core using more overcharges. Is it going to use more overcharges? No, it's not. Finally using those up now. Three attacks at the same time, going to be doing quite a lot of damage, but at the same time there's so many Zerg units here that it could result very, very badly for Firecake. Now there is an Immortal and a Disruptor in the back here, so they could do a nice chunk of damage if, for example, they hit it right there. But at the same time, this Nexus is now going down very, very quickly. He needs to get those disruptions out, otherwise he will die very, very quickly. Now that one roach I believe was dead already, but it just got blown the hell away once that Purification Nova hit. This Nexus has just been destroyed, so again denying that base. A fourth base actually going down at the same time, about to be completed. And how much is ShoWTime going to be able to hold on here? He's closed the gap quite considerably between himself and Firecake. So is he going to be able to hold on? I honestly don't know. I think that if he can, he needs to get a few units up, and then straight after that pretty much expand, do a double expand out of it to bring his economy up to standard. The same standard that Firecake has it on at the moment. Now the Zerg is coming around here, gonna probably get its round. Oh, this is gonna be a nice Purification Nova. Manages to get 3 Ravagers with that. Very, very well played there. Again, reducing the number of supply from the Protoss, but a nice corrosive bile here, catching out quite a few units behind that stuck refinery. Some more pylons going down. That is probably for more overcharges. Unfortunately, the Mothership Core doesn't actually have much energy. Maybe just a reduce the power of the Zerg surround. Now throwing down another Nexus, as I thought, a second expansion off the back of this defense would be very, very beneficial to him. Now if Firekick continues with this aggression, which it does indeed look like, it 24 Zerglings on the way, which actually technically means I believe 20 or 48 if I'm not mistaken. No, I think this actually counts the... Yeah, it's actually counting the amount of Zerglings that's going to come out, not the amount of eggs that are there. So there we go, they do run into this base, spotting it pretty much straight away. He knows that ShoWTime is wanting to get more time to build up his defenses and build up his units. But is he going to give him that? I honestly don't think so. Lots and lots of damage going down. The Purification Nova missing on this occasion. And supply again, 60 supply lead for ShoWTime. A huge Purification over there, bringing that down to about 50. So quite effective damage here. Let's look at this army supply. ShoWTime absolutely dominating with the numbers. How long is ShoWTime, or sorry, FireCake dominating with the numbers. How long is ShoWTime going to be able to hold on here? I do believe, oh, he does manage to break into the main base. There's only three disruptors left. Going to throw down Purification Nova. Hitting a few units there, and there we go. A few probes starting to drop also with these Zerglings on the side here. No response here from ShoWTime. Firekick now on five bases in total. That's actually fully saturated also. So I'm predicting a GG very, very shortly here. 16 probes destroyed in total, which is actually this entire base. The main and natural still holding on here. ShoWTime pretty much doing everything he can. If he gets a few nice Purification Novas, he could still be in the game. I mean, it's not completely over yet, but honestly, looking at it realistically, if this continues the way it's going right now, and look at the minimap, so many reinforcements being streamed in all the time. If it continues like this, it's going to be over very, very shortly. But is he doing something about it? Yes, he is. He does have level 2 weapons on the way, throwing out those Purification Novas, getting some really nice hits. And honestly, I don't know why he doesn't have these Purification Novas or these Disruptors out a lot earlier. Last time when he was playing against Probe, he absolutely decimated Probe with the Purification Novas because he had such beautiful hits with them. And every one of these Purification Novas, they're in about a 20-second cooldown, if I remember right. 2021, am I correct? 12-second cooldown. Oh no, that's halfway through. So yeah, about 22-second cooldown on Purification Novas, which, you know, it could be quite significant. If you manage to destroy a lot of units with it, boom! Look at all those roaches getting absolutely wiped out there. That was huge. That could be pretty much all that's required to hold on against this push. You know, more and more getting destroyed, Purification Novas, but at the same time, the supply is constantly favoring Firecake, and the resources in this main base and the natural expansion are quickly running out. He is getting mined out very, very quickly. If this continues, he won't be able to hold on. But he has done such a brilliant defense with these disruptors so far. Another Purification Nova going down. Wow, losing all of those roaches. So many units getting destroyed. How many units are these Disruptors have at this point? 11, 8, and 2 on that one, and 15 on that one. So these Disruptors, absolutely men of the match, or machines of the match, I suppose, in this case. He is deciding to reinforce all of his units. There we go, rallying them all together. Honestly, he needs to expand here. If he doesn't expand, he will be completely out of minerals very, very shortly. Look at this base here. Total of 8 mining probes, and only 2 here, or 1 actually. So very, very quickly going to lose minerals here. He is getting a nice bit of supply. Looking at the income, he's actually keeping up with the Zerg just about. A Spire also coming down, and 30 Zerglings. I wonder, is he going to try to run these Zerglings into the main and the natural expansion? That would possibly be a good idea since he can just completely overrun this base. Does decide to bring out 2 Archons here. So the Archons could potentially turn the tide here. This Overlord pooping down a little bit of creep. Going to be denying any sort of possibility for expansion. Now these minerals are going to start to mine out soon as well, so it's going to be now or never ShoWTime. These Zerglings, oh my god, perfect surrounds onto those disruptors, and very, very well played here, taking those out. Once these are out, all of the response from ShoWTime is going to be over. And how is this going to play out? There's 3 Archons on the field at the moment. More Zealots being warped in as well. A few probes taken out at the same time with the Zerglings. There we go. They actually did manage to run into the main base. Runs them in here. Going to be taken out. Pretty much the gas probes. Another disruptor on the way also. I'm going to have a quick look. How much is Fire ShoWTime actually aware of? He's actually aware of pretty much everything except for this expansion. So he knows how far behind he is at the moment. These Zerglings running around. Are they going to intercept this disruptor? No, they're not. Another Archon being warped in. And there we go. He is denying more mining inside of this natural. A lot of probes here. I think that he really needs to potentially try to get like a sneaky base. There we go. A GG is called here. Firecake taking the series 3-0. Very well played here with so much aggression off the back of 5 bases. So there you go, that was a 3-0 for Firecake. Very, very well played here. I have to say that this consistent aggression very, very well suits his style. I have to commend him for this play style. Taking out ShoWTime 3-0 is quite an achievement. ShoWTime, a very, very good Protoss player. So that's pretty much it. I'll end the video here. My social media links are on the right hand side here. My subscribe button is underneath my face as well as underneath the video. I'll see you guys in the next series, which you will probably see later on today or tomorrow. Good luck, take care, bye bye.